Call me up, I've been calling you. It's 2 a.m. and I want you to. Shots from the bartender. I wanna ride with you. We can be more than we meant to be.
It might be this time. I think.
Welcome back to One on One with Honey. I know I've been gone for a minute, but I'm back. And I've got some amazing guests and some great interviews, and I can't wait to share with you all. But today I have here Rochelle and Kamden, the founders of Bleau Swimwear. So hi guys.
Hi.
How are you guys today?
Good.
Looking pretty as always.
Thank you.
So guys, I just want to get straight into it. So Bleau Swimwear, how did it start? Where did this idea come from?
It's quite crazy actually. I don't know, you know, me and Kamden travel quite a lot from young and love fashion, swimwear, anything to do with holidays.
Yeah.
Just a casual conversation as we do, we're sitting down, just talking about our ideas and what we want to do. And I think, if I remember straight, Kam was like, I really want to do swimwear in this part of the Caribbean. And I was like, yeah, I really want to do swimwear in that part of the Caribbean. And we was like, you know what? Let's actually make it something. Let's do it.
Okay.
And then from there, obviously.
So you guys are friends previously before Bleau Swimwear.
Yes.
So how does that work now? Do you kind of divvy up roles? Is one specialise in one thing and the other in the other? Like, how does that
work?
Do
you know, I feel like it worked well with us because, I mean, we were friends, but we weren't as close as we are now.
Mm.
So when we started, I think you could say it was very early on, like we just kind of was getting to know each other. So we didn't have like a long history where there was a whole lot of like already like an attachment or a relationship together. So it's kind of like we knew each other. We knew that, oh yeah, you're cool, like whatever. And we kind of started like hanging around with each other, but it wasn't necessarily like a proper, a form, you could say, strong friendship. And then
definitely.
when we started, obviously, as time went on, I think, well, the beginning stages, we literally just did whatever, like the two of us, oh, I'll do this, you do that, I'll do this.
Yeah.
I guess now as time has gone, we realize each other's strengths and weaknesses, so we can be honest with each other and say, okay, well, I'm good at this, I think you're a bit better at that.
Yeah.
If we face this, then I'm gonna take that on, you take that on because you've got more experience in that sector. So we just kind of juggle between the both, knowing roles. You focus on that more, I'm gonna focus on this more.
So what happens when, say, like there's a design, one of you likes it, the other doesn't?
Yeah.
Like you're both honest with each other in them kind of situations as well.
I think luckily we both kind of are on the same wave, we both like the same similar stuff. But when that happens, I feel like we just Cam might be like,
This is why I like this. And obviously, I think when we started, we realized that we like the same things, but our styles are slightly different.
Mm-hmm.
But that was a good thing for us because it's two is better than one. So what I might like might appeal to a certain amount of people, but what Rochelle likes will appeal to other people. So I obviously, our objective is the same. We know that we want to create something for everyone. So if I know that I might not like something she designed, but I've got to think beyond just what I can see.
Definitely. Well, Bleau has had amazing success, so I just want to congratulate the both of you.
Thank you.
I love it. I've been to some of your events. They're always great, and I just love it. What I wanted to know is that with such competition in the swimwear world, like, and you've got the Pretty Little Things, the Missy Empires, how do you overcome that? Like, how do you push forward?
I don't think they've ever been our competition.
No.
So I just think that what we're trying to do is very different to the Pretty Little Things. We're not trying to provide swimwear that you could find on Pretty Little Thing, or because I feel like there's enough of that, and they're great. I love Pretty Little Thing and Missy Empire, all those kind of brands. But I would say Bleau is a lot more, a bit more of a niche product.
Mm-hmm.
Someone who is, you're not gonna find it everywhere, and that's what we love, and we know that. So we know, you know, I don't see them as on our kind of competition.
Yeah.
Type of thing.
Okay, that's really great, and also, like, this is huge. Being in Vogue, in Tatla, amazing. How do you get there? Like, how does that come about? Because not everyone gets that chance, like, especially the swim world, like, there's a lot of people out there with swimwear brands, but only a few are noticed, and yours has obviously been noticed. So mm-hmm. how does that feel?
I think in terms of how you get there, I don't think we have a answer like this is what you need to do, but I can say is being persistent and consistent with your goals and whatever you're trying to achieve.
Yeah.
Because that's literally, I mean, all we did. We was approached actually from them directly.
Yeah.
And they was like, we like your stuff, it looks fantastic. I mean, we were just like gobsmacked. I mean, I think we was at work, wasn't we? And was emailing each other like, oh, Kamden's like, I gotta go to the bathroom. I'm like, yeah, so do I, I gotta cry. Like, it was all too much. So I mean, you're saying how does it feel? It feels fantastic to know that what you're doing isn't unnoticed. And you know, I would just say a word of advice is just bear that in mind. So always put your best foot forward, because you don't know who's
looking. They're all watching you.
They're,
so
they're all watching.
You might think, no one's really watching us.
Just
but
my social media followers.
Yeah, but there's teams that are out there and they search for companies. Everyone wants the new thing. So you might have a new brand and it's like, there's definitely corporations that are looking for the new next big thing. So if they see something that they like or see something special, and they're gonna go through with a very fine tooth comb and look at everything that you've ever done, and if they see and they're like, no, I actually like this brand, then I think you just kind of got to work on your product. So
does social media play a factor in this?
Definitely.
They actually said they found us through Instagram.
You wouldn't think it, because I mean, so in this age we've only got about 1,000, just over 1,000 followers.
Yeah.
So that's not a lot at all. But you then, like, the same thing. People are not, just because you've got 10,000 followers doesn't mean that a huge company is gonna bypass you because you've only got 1,000. So it's a matter of the product. They can see the work effort, and I feel like they've been in the game for years. So someone like Vogue can see like a genuine company who is different.
Yeah.
You know,
you've also had quite a few social influencers as well. So you've had Ashanti in your swimwear, you've had dancer Aaliyah Janelle, you've had reality star Henchar.
Yeah.
So to be able to get them in your swimwear, how does that feel, and how does it actually have an effect on the business?
I would say it's obviously fantastic, and it feels so rewarding to find that, you know, these big, so, you know, influencers want to wear Bleu.
Yeah.
And I'd like to say, obviously, as well, we haven't paid anyone.
None of them are
paid.
Never
paid
someone
to wear
Bleu. Because I'm always hearing, you know, these people pay this person.
Any
influencers, because they genuinely like the product and they've seen it and they want to wear it. We've not gone down that route of necessarily paying. We've kind of said that we're careful with what influencers that we want representing our brand, and we don't just want to like throw a lot of money out to be like, please just wear it. Nice to know, like, the likes of Ashanti, she's worn it like 3 times now.
Yeah,
and she's like body gold.
But her wearing it shows that she likes the product, and that's what we're more concerned about. Being a new brand, it's more about really taking the steps. Okay, is our product good enough, and how are people responding to it?
So when you say is your product good enough, how much time does go into actually curating that product and making sure that it's the best that it can be?
Months.
Yeah.
A really long time.
Yeah, a really long time.
Because I mean, it's really all trial and error. Neither of us studied fashion or design.
Or background.
So we just kind of, we're very self-taught. So anything we do, from the designing to the sampling, pattern making, we
everything.
Do all ourselves.
So you kind of studied this industry as you've gone along as well?
Yeah, as the time's gone on, YouTube, asking, people are so fed up of us, because anyone that we find that is willing to help us, we just ask them a million questions go back and forth.
Because sometimes people feel a bit apprehensive about asking people and things like that. You don't want people to think maybe you're dumb or like what you're doing or sometimes I'm a bit like that. I'm a bit like, should I ask? I don't know. So how do you kind of do that kind of networking
I don't
thing,
care. Me, yeah. I say I'm shameless. You can say that, but I am. I don't care. If I have a goal and I need to do something, like, I'm not going to do anything. But if it's just a matter of, putting my pride aside and asking a question that might make me look dumb, I'm going to ask a question because I might get the answer. So I don't really care what I look like.
I need to take that on board. I need to just go for it and just not care. Seriously.
Once you've got a vision and a goal, depending on how serious you are about getting there, asking a question is the least.
Yeah.
We're in our factory sitting down with the man saying, so how are you doing that? What are you doing there? Like, you know, but you know, we have knowledge now. So when we're doing new collections, we know in order for it to go this way, you know, we've learned that, you know, you need to do it X, Y, and Z way.
How important is it for you to be part every step of the way? You just said you'd be in the factory with them, like, be part of everything.
Everything.
Why can't you just give it to them at the factory to make and just get your samples back and be like, oh no, but the change has changed this. Why do you feel like it's important to actually be there?
I feel like because when we entered this, we didn't necessarily come into it with a kind of a background in the area. So we want to learn as well, and we want to make sure that the end product is as perfect as it can be. And I feel like if you kind of just leave things, which when we started, I think at the beginning, with the first woman that we worked with, we kind of just left her to kind of do the samples. And it took such a long time because and we money. Wasn't, yeah, a lot of money and time wasted because we weren't, our eyes weren't on it as close as possible. Whereas if we have as much influence as possible, we're gonna create what we actually want to see, so.
Yeah.
Another great achievement of yours is being in Miami Swim Week. So for those who don't know what Miami Swim Week is, explain it to us.
So Miami Swim Week is literally like the London Fashion Week of swimwear. So if you've got a swimwear brand, then you need to be in Miami Swim Week. There'll be loads of buyers, retailers, shows, events, exhibitions, you name it. Just all sorts of swim fantastic.
How did it feel being a part of that?
Oh, it was fantastic.
It was fantastic. Obviously, it was our first year. It was our first time ever being a part of anything like that. So it was more of a learning curve, but it did feel fantastic to be amongst, you know, these swimwear brands that, you know, we look up to and we admire.
Yeah.
So being amongst them was just, it was amazing. And I can't wait to go back. Yeah. See you there.
So you've also done a few pop-up stores. How important are they for coming up brands to do a pop-up store?
Yeah, good.
Yeah, I think a pop-up store is fundamental for online brands because I guess, you know, you're able to connect, you know, via social media, email marketing, etc. But it's fantastic for people to be able to get an opportunity to actually come down and see your stuff, feel it, you know, actually meet you is important. So I found that we've had quite a lot of interest, you know, following our pop-ups and people being excited, messaging us happy to actually even come down and meet us, you know, and actually get a chance to see the stuff. Try it on, which is also key. I find that is important. So yeah, I would say it is a fantastic thing for online brands to do every now and then.
Especially a new brand, because I feel like when it takes a lot to build like customer trust.
Yeah.
So like with a new clothing brand, it's like for people to just randomly buy up for this brand new website, you don't know, like, oh, can I trust them or not? So then it's really good if someone's and they're from like London, they're like, oh yeah, they've got a pop-up that's in London, it's not far, I'm gonna go there, I can actually see the product and see the quality of it. And there was a few girls that would come down and they'd be like, wow, like, I never knew the quality was this good, and now I know, now I can buy more. And you know, but they might have been more hesitant to actually just make that first purchase because they don't really know.
That's amazing. But what is next for Bleau Swimwear?
Lots.
Give me some secrets now.
If you notice at the end of our last collection, we did launch Baby Bleau, which was, I'm proud to say, we actually won the first in our kind of industry to do matching swimwear with babies.
That is so cute.
Yeah, so like mini me's. So we will be touching back on that again.
That's good.
A little insight I can give you.
Yeah.
Everything else we might have to say.
I've got
a wait
for it.
Yeah.
No, it's amazing everything that you've done with Bleau Swimwear, and I just love you guys anyway, and I've always been and I love it. And thanks for joining me today as well, and being like my first guest back on Black Woman, honey. It's really.
And congratulations to you too.
Yeah, congratulations.
Thank you
for having us.
Thank you. Wow. And guys, all their details will be in the description.